Hello friends, so today we are gonna start with a new chapter called as complex number. Now let's understand what is the meaning of complex number. So guys, from the childhood you all are learning the different types of numbers. So you all know what are the real numbers, what are the whole numbers, what are the integer numbers and everything. So real numbers you can count like 1, 2, 3 or minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 till negative infinity or positive infinity. So similarly, let's understand what is complex number and why exactly complex number come into existence. And why exactly the complex number came into existence. So guys, if I ask you a simple question, what is the square root of 9? So you all would say it is plus 3 or minus 3, and that's correct. But if I ask you what is the square root of negative 9, so now it's very difficult to tell the square root, because we say, or you have been learning from the school days, that square root of negative number does not exist. So exactly. So if I want to find out the square root of negative number, how would I find it out? So we can find it out, or we can find out the square root of negative number by or with the help of complex numbers. So guys, if I want to find out the square root of negative 9, then I would say it is square root of minus 1 into 9, which is 3. And square root of minus 1 is I. Now you must be thinking, sir, what is this I? So guys, don't worry, to explain this I am here. So now let's start with the complex number. I'll first explain you the definition and the form of a complex number, and then you will understand what is the meaning of this I. So complex number, so any number which is given in the form x plus iy. So x we generally call it as a real part, and this iy we call it as imaginary part. Now why imaginary part? So it's simple, because with this part, can you observe one symbol which is written as I? So due to this I, it is called as imaginary part. So basically a complex number is a combination of real and imaginary part. It's so easy. So whenever you see such type of combination, we will be calling it as complex number. So guys, here can you see that the answer is 3i? So here we have I, so we can call it as a complex number. But yes, it is a different type of complex number. So I'll come to that part. So x plus iy is a complex number, or any number of the form x plus iy is called as complex number. And the value of I in the complex number is square root of minus 1. So let's take everything together. So it means any number of the form x plus iy, where x and y are real. So the meaning of this line is, if I take x and y separate, then they both are real. It means the value of x and y will be between negative infinity to positive infinity. Or in simple words, I would say that we all have studied the number line in school days, okay? So whatever number that you can represent on the number line, all those numbers are the real numbers. So basically x and y can carry any value. So it can be a negative value, it can be a negative fraction, it can be a positive fraction, or the positive integer. So these are real. Next, the value of I is square root of minus 1. So such number is called as complex number. So in this, x will be called as real part, and iy, or here we call this part as the imaginary part, because it is always preceded by I symbol. So this is about the complex number. Now let's come to our example. So in our example we got 3i. It means here we have imaginary part, but we don't have real part. So guys, whenever in a complex number, here I'll say, whenever in a complex number the x part is 0, our complex number, which is generally denoted by z, will be IY. So Z is a complex number, X plus IY. So in this, I am saying that the real part is 0. So that time we are just getting IY, that is imaginary part. So such number is called as purely imaginary number. Now guys, let's come to the other part. Is it possible that this y can be 0? Yes. So whenever this second part iy is 0, that time, so y is 0, it means iy is 0, that time our z will be x. So it means now in this number there is no imaginary part. So if there is no imaginary part, or if there is only real part, then it becomes our real number. So it is called as purely real number. So guys, we have seen the definition of complex number, how to identify the complex number, and what is purely real and purely imaginary number. So whenever you see a number z equal to x plus iy, it is complex number. But guys, let me tell you a specific term. This is also called as Cartesian form of complex number. So in next videos, we are gonna see different forms of complex number. So one of the form is Cartesian form, other two are polar and exponential form. So whenever we have a number in the form x plus iy, this is called as Cartesian form, or it is also called as a standard form of complex number. Now standard means it will have only one real part and one imaginary part. So here you can see that x is a single real part and iy is a single imaginary part. So such numbers are also called as standard form, or here I would say it is Cartesian form. So z equal to x plus iy is a standard form or the Cartesian form of a complex number. So guys, now based on this, we are gonna solve the numericals in the following videos.